हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। सो मीटिंग आफ्टर अ वन डे ब्रेक फॉर होम्योपैथिक सेशन। यस्टरडे वी हैव डिस्कस्ड रिगार्डिंग द डायबिटीज। इट वॉज इन मराठी, दैट्स वाई फ्यू ऑफ द कैंडिडेट्स हु डजंट नो द मराठी, they had the problem in understanding, but it was for laymen, and that's why it should be discussed in local language, and that's why I have conducted that session in Marathi. But today we're going to learn this diabetes and its therapeutics with the help of few mother tinctures. Before going into the subject, I want to discuss few questions which were asked in previous lectures, and that's why we'll first finish them and then we'll go ahead. First question was asked three times that, sir, please explain the doses of mother tinctures while explaining the mother tinctures. My suggestion is that whenever you are giving mother tinctures, again you have to follow the law of minimum dose over there. Law of minimum dose means you have to give a minimum quantity. Here it is a little bit material, and that's why at least 10 to 20, 15 drops twice a day or thrice a day, depending upon the situation, you have to use. It also depends for what purpose you are giving the mother tinctures, whether you are giving those mother tinctures for the diabetes mellitus, for heart conditions, for asthma, for epilepsy. It varies, application varies and dose varies. So it is not possible to define doses every time. It is a part and parcel of judgment. It is part and parcel of understanding those things. So whenever a question of potency comes or doses comes, repetition comes, my suggestion is always that you have to learn them in the clinics only. When you observe that when I'm prescribing certain mother tincture, you have to understand why sir has given this three times a day, why he has given him four times a day, or why he has said only once a day. You have to understand that it depends upon the situation, it depends upon judgment, it depends upon what type of disease for which I'm prescribing it. It depends upon the susceptibility of the individual. So it is not only one thing on which you are going to decide fixed doses of the mother tinctures. So every time it varies. It varies from person to person. So ultimately, whenever you are considering regarding the doses, yes, from today onwards, I will going to discuss those while discussing the condition, but they will not be a fixed. It varies from person to person. And for that purpose only, the clinical learning is very essential. Generally, what happens, we never learn clinically. In homeopathy, number of students, they start practice directly after listening the seminars and after reading the books. But reading the books and listening the seminars is not the ideal way of learning. Year, you must learn with someone who is practicing homeopathy since long time, because that he is having the knowledge regarding the subject, and he is those homeopathic practitioners who are able to explain why they have given such and such medicines and in certain doses. There must be a logic behind that. You must learn that logic, you must learn that understanding of potency and repetition, so that you grasp that very easily. So there will be no fear in your mind while utilizing the mother tincture. So a fixed entity is not there regarding the mother tinctures, but still I will try my level best to explain while explaining the other mother tincture. There was one more question. That question was related with the company combinations. Yes. One question, someone asked me that, sir, there are number of formulas are there, R11 or B20, such types of B11, such types of combinations are there. So whether we can use those combinations in our practice and what it produces. My suggestion is that these are not at all useful in your practice. They are having a palliative role sometimes only, depending upon the situation of person's health and condition. One of the ingredients it founds to be similimum, sometimes, very occasionally, you can get that or you can catch a cure in such types of combination. So, 1 in 1,000 or 1 in 10,000, you can get such types of results in with the combinations, but you cannot get a consecutive results, or you cannot understand exactly what is happening after giving the combination. Yes, definitely some amount of or some part of palliation you can get, because there are number of ingredients which are used in combinations and they palliate the situation in such conditions. So that is the first important thing which you have to understand while using the combination. Don't use combination. In fact, learn homeopathy and apply with the help of knowledge of medicines, and apply your own medicines and use them separately. Second reason why not to use the combination is that these medicines are prepared before doing a pharmacological procedure over there. So it is not a mixture, it is combined together and then trituratored or then potentized, and that's why the properties becomes different. So you cannot get exact properties what you expect over there, and that's why it never works in such types of condition. So that is second question. I will not go for these questions, combination. Third question was there. It is a good question. It is just a question I will tell you, because this can happen or this can be a possibility that certain newcomers in the homeopathy or certain people who doesn't have the concepts of homeopathy clear may ask such types of questions with you. And that's why this question I will discuss without telling the name of the person. I am suffering from tonsillitis, so I take Phytolacca 30, one dose, feeling better, but drug's action is it has been explained that drug is having action on mammary gland. Can it affect at that place now or in future? Basically, when you are taking any homeopathic medicine, it in the diluted form or in the potentized form, it will not work or it will not produce any pathological action. It is not the Phytolacca 30 which will going to produce a material effect on the body. It is Phytolacca 30 is a stimulus. So human reacts to that stimulus. It is not the action of Phytolacca which will going to happen or which will going to work on the patient, but it is the reaction of the vital force against the Phytolacca stimulus that will going to happen. So no homeopathic medicine in the potentized form produces its effects directly. It only shows functional symptoms, and those functional symptoms are nothing but the reactions of the vital force against that specific dynamic stimulus. So if you are, you must learn the concepts of dynamics clearly so that you can understand them, and then such types of fear disappears. So even if any patient comes to you, you should be very firm that homeopathic medicine never produces primary action. It never causes any type of side effects in the human being. This is very important. You should be very firm. Whatever happens is the reaction of the human being, and it is against the dynamic stimulus. It is as if a reaction which you are giving to your friends, you are giving to your colleagues, whatever he says, that stimulus is there, you are reacting to that situation, or at present, whatever I am talking with you, you are reacting to that situation, is a dynamic reaction. And such types of reactions happens because of homeopathic medicine, because after 12C potency, whatever medicine given in homeopathy doesn't carry the material inside it. It carries only the properties. And that's why such type of primary symptoms or primary effects, primary action never happens with the help of homeopathic medicines. So these are the questions which were asked for the today's session, and then we'll go ahead with the discussion of the diabetes and the homeopathic aspect or approach towards the homeopathic aspect. Yesterday I have told you regarding the details about diabetes mellitus. I think it was very much digestible for everyone. Today I will going to share different aspects of this diabetes mellitus. I have told in short that diabetes mellitus, generally the dominating miasm is psychotubercular, or it might be, if it is type 1 diabetes mellitus, most commonly it is the syphilitic miasm. So the common entity type 2 diabetes mellitus generally falls in second variety, that is the psychotic miasm. When you are dealing with the diabetes patients, you have to manage that case. You don't have to just give a medicine. If a patient of a diabetes mellitus comes and you give certain mother tinctures and patient will be cured, it's not so. There are number of patients who get completely cured from the type 2 diabetes mellitus with the help of proper homeopathic management. Sometimes patient comes to you with a allopathic medicine which is already going on since long time. Number of students never knows how to reduce or how to taper those. My suggestion, that is a practical suggestion for all of you, is that when you start your homeopathic medicine, basically you have to advise them a diet. If you are advising the diet which I have yesterday told in yesterday's lecture, that twice a day, early in the morning the lunch and early in the evening the dinner, finish two times a day. If you are changing the diet of the patient, most important thing, tell the patient to reduce the allopathic medicines up to the half of the dose. So if they are consuming any tablet, you must reduce it half. If they are consuming insulin, reduce the dose to the half, and they should have a glucometer so that accordingly they can reduce or further check the blood sugar every time, and whether to they require further dose of insulin or not, that they can decide. There is a case I will suggest to you. There was a patient who was with me, who came to me only for the purpose of a secondary in the bones. She was a patient from near Kolkata, and she knows that I am treating the cancers, and she called me, and she was just diagnosed the day yesterday, before that she is having multiple secondaries in all the bones, whole spinal cord and all the bones. Her weight was 96. She was having diabetes mellitus, she was having hypertension, she was having hypothyroidism, and she was in very much stress because the doctor told her that your life is not more than 3 months. So she called me. I told her that if you want to start homeopathic medicines, I want to tell you the exact way, diet as well as everything you have to follow. Then she said, I agree, but doctor, I'm taking 16 units in the morning, 16 units in the afternoon, and 18 units in the evening. Three times I'm taking the insulin. So how to reduce that? I said, if you are going to follow my diet, you have to reduce it, and I will let you know. So I asked her, tomorrow morning, you can start the diet. I asked her to take a diet only twice a day. Before that, she used to take every 2 hours the food. Every 2 hours, till she sleeps. So right from the early in the morning till night, she was continuously taking something every 2 hours. So I asked her that you stop the that thing only twice a day. You have to take the food, and you start with the 8 units in the morning, half of the dose, and in afternoon don't take directly a medicine. Better way is to check the blood sugar. If it is down, you should not take the next dose. In the evening, again check before the dinner, how much is the dose, how much is the sugar. And in this way, I asked her. So next day, from next day, there were no insulin required for that patient. It was stopped because every time it was coming down, 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 and nothing. So I have started medicine. I have asked for diet, and it has stopped completely. Even she never required Sijijam Jambolikam or any mother tincture also. So you have to, first important thing, you have to tackle with those allopathic medicines. Yesterday only I have a new case with having similar problem. I have asked her to reduce the doses in the similar manner regarding the insulin. But if the patient is on tablets, and number of patients are on metformin, you reduce it to the half. So if they are taking one tablet in the morning, one tablet in the evening, ask them to reduce half of the tablet in the morning, half in the evening, and ask them a perfect diet, which I have advised you. And then think of giving a medicine. Here, your constitutional medicine is very important. You have to discuss, or you have to find it out, that remedy of that patient. So that how to come to the conclusion of a constitutional antimiasmatic remedy, everyone knows. So that is not part of today's lecture. But constitutional antimiasmatic remedy is very, very essential, so that you can find it out, that dynamic cause which was responsible to produce a disorder, diabetes, over there. So at one side you are handling the cause of the disease with the help of antimiasmatic constitutional remedy, and at the another point you have to tackle the sugar, acute sugar also. Both things you have to do. So here I suggest that homeopathic management, it is too important to say. So first important part of your treatment is or management is the auxiliary measures. In auxiliary measures, the diet plays very important role. Second important is exercise, 1 hour a day, whatever it may be. It might be a cycling, it might be walking, it might be running, it might be yoga, it might be any other exercises, but at least 1 hour for oneself. And then constitutional remedy, first doses, followed with, if the patient is having any proper specific symptoms of a certain remedy, that remedy you can give. If there are certain patients who comes to you at diabetic claudications, so patient is having diabetic claudications, you have to think about the biochemic remedy also. Here, Calcarea Pure plays very important role. Calcarea Pure and Calcarea Foss, which both are very important in such cases. And that's why you have to think about the such a combination which will take care of that claudications also. Sometimes you might require, patient is having tremendous cramps in the lower extremities, you have to think about any acute remedy. It varies. That might be any acute remedy for time being. Constitutional will work with its own speed, with its own pace. Acute remedy will take care of an acute problem. Along with, you have to use a homeopathic remedy which will decrease the sugar. Yes, like we have to use a material medicines also. And for that purpose, homeopathic mother tinctures plays very important role. So in such types of cases, I generally use three types of mother tinctures, out of which first I used to prefer always, and that is everyone knows, is Sijijam Jambolikam. So that mother tincture I used to start if the patient's sugar are too high. If patient's sugar are not too high, I will not going to start with that. At that time, I will going to start with only with the chronic remedy, constitutional remedy, along with a homeopathic medicine, if required, a biochemic medicine. If sugars are too much, then I add the syngium jambolicum. Syngium jambolicum I generally use in the doses 15 drops in a half a cup of water in the morning and in the evening before lunch and before dinner. 5 to 10 minutes before lunch and before dinner. This is the dose I generally start with depending upon the situation. And I taper the allopathic medicines the way I have told you. So this is the first mother tincture I used to use in such types of cases. Now let us learn this syngium germ. When to use syngium and why the syngium. You will get very typical features if you have Borix Materia Medica with you. You open your Borix Materia Medica. Very nicely Borix has mentioned regarding this, the clinical aspect of that remedy, and we'll go sentence by sentence so that you can understand the specific action of syngium jambolicum. Basically it is an Indian remedy, very clearly mentioned in Borix, and it is commonly we used to use in our diet also, or in the form of fruits, jambol seeds. The active principle is very important, that enlexing is the active principle. Immediate effect of that enlexing is that it, if there is an increased blood sugar or if there is a glycosuria, it has a capacity to reduce that. So that is very important part in the syngium jambolicum. So that reduces acute sugar. So to tackle those sugars, it is very important to give. It is not that you have to continue it every time. It depends. If patient starts getting recovery, if you are able to stop complete allopathic medicines and you have shifted him on the syngium germ and your constitutional remedy, after some time it happens that patient never requires even syngium germ. Yesterday only I have stopped the syngium germ of one patient because he is continuously having blood sugar around fasting around 70 to 80 and PPP around 110 to 120. So I reduced every time. Now it was only 5 drops in the morning and 5 drops in the evening was going on. I asked him to stop, cut down and just check it every 15 days. So in such types of cases, you can get such types of results with the help of mother tinctures, and that you have to reduce later on after finishing or after stopping the allopathic medicines. What he says regarding the syngium germ, the most powerful remedy in diabetes mellitus. See, first sentence itself is very important. Most powerful remedy. No other remedy causes in so marked degree of the diminution and disappearance of the sugar in the urine. It is given in italics. So in homeopathy, this is a good, very good homeopathic remedy which can be used in mother tincture form in sugar, in reducing the acute sugar. Then one more sentence which is given in italics, that is prickly heat in the upper part of the body. Prickly heat is very important thing. The patient explains up to this level there are minute small spots over there. आपण जसं घामोळ्या येतात त्या घामोळ्यांसारखे बारीक 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 इरप्शन्स येतात, ते रेडिस असतात आणि त्याच्यामुळे शरीर वरचा पार्ट खूप गरम लागतो. दॅट इज व्हेरी टिपिकल फ्युचर. दॅट लुक्स व्हेरी हॉट. अप्पर पार्ट ऑफ द बॉडी इट लुक्स व्हेरी हॉट अँड देर आर माइन्यूट स्मॉल पॅप्युलर, व्हेरी स्मॉल पॅप्युलर रॅश विच यू कॅन फाइंड इट आउट ऑन द फेस, ऑन द शोल्डर, समटाइम्स ऑन द चेस्ट. And patient explains that, doctor, this was not there, this is happening since last few months. This indicates that patient is requiring the syngium jambolicum. Small red pimples which itch violently, see, small red pimples which itch violently, the prachanda khajavto patient, that is very important feature. Great thirst and weakness and emaciation, three things, all typical upper diabetes mellitus. Great thirst, there is tremendous thirst, there is tremendous weakness, and along with that, tremendous emaciation, loss of flesh is very important feature which is there in diabetes mellitus. So think about this remedy in such types of features. So features are indicating yes, patient requires the CGM jambolicum. Then he says, very large amount of urine, specific gravity is very high, diabetic ulcerations. So this remedy is having action on the skin, producing diabetic ulcerations, means the ulcerations which are late healing or non-healing ulcers, which you can tackle with the help of this remedy. So this is very typical presentation of a diabetes mellitus, which you can get in CGM jambolicum, and you can use it along with your allopathic medicines first, and then start tapering all those allopathic medicines gradually. So first half the dose, and then you follow after 15 days, do a blood sugar, and every time ask the patient to do a fasting PP, both blood sugar, so that you can handle the situation very clearly. Sometimes you can have your own sugar scan. If a patient comes, check the sugar, so you can be immediately confirm it very easily. Dose is tincture. So dose he has mentioned regarding the mother tincture. Relationship is mentioned, and that relationship here defines one more remedy which I was not using since long time, but last 2 years I am using it, and I am having very good results with that remedy. In fact, it was not available, number of times I have asked, but not now, it is quite commonly available, and that remedy which is used as a sarcode, the insulin. Compare the insulin. An aqueous solution of an active principle from pancreas which affects the sugar metabolism. See what he mentions about the insulin. Every sentence is very useful, and I am using this infrequent doses every weekly, and that settles patient very easily. Even I have told in yesterday's session a case of a juvenile diabetes, and I am repeating this insulin regularly in that case, every weekly 3 doses, and that was because of that he was able to control the or his blood sugar levels are quite controlled after using the insulin 30 or insulin 12C. I used to use 3 doses and every weekly. So what he says regarding insulin, if administered at the suitable intervals in diabetes mellitus, the blood sugar is maintained at a normal level. See, this is too important to understand. Blood sugar is maintained at a normal interval because of using those in doses of insulin in infrequently. Overdoses is followed by weakness and fatigue and tremulousness and profuse sweating. So if you used to use it regularly in repeated doses, sometimes it causes and weakness because of hypoglycemia. And that's why if you are giving this insulin, give infrequent doses, and this is a good remedy I will suggest you. Generally, even in type 1 diabetes mellitus, give insulin 30 or insulin 12C infrequent doses, and you can see the results that you can tackle the diabetes very easily in such types of cases. So this is one more remedy, one more thing. But if you will ask me whether to give a constitutional or not, you have to give constitutional and semilimum. Insulin you can use as an infrequent doses, because this is a sarcode which can be used in because it depends, it looks like an isopathic prescription, but such medicines always helps to tackle such pathological conditions in the human being. So two remedies which we have discussed, insulin in homeopathic doses, that is in potentized form, and CGM jump in mother tincture form. So basically, whenever I handle the cases of diabetes mellitus, this is my aspect that I used to ask them regarding the diet, second exercise, And third part then comes is the constitutional antimiasmatic remedy, followed by an acute remedy, and if requires, the mother tincture, out of which first mother tincture I have discussed is Sigigium Jambolicum. Second mother tincture, few of the students might be knowing, but number of students might not be knowing, because this is an Indian drug which is not mentioned in regular Materia Medica. It is mentioned in the Materia Medica, in the Borix Materia Medica, at the end in the Indian remedies, and that is Gymnemna sylvestri. It is Gymnemna, Gymnemna sylvester. And this is again an Indian drug, and which is very, very useful in tackling the diabetes mellitus. My thought goes in favor of little bit with the allopathic aspects. You might be getting that my thought, because I have learned with the number of peoples, and that logic is I used to use in homeopathy also, and that's why number of times I follow their logic also. So after a long period of using Sigigium Jam, sometimes I shift the Sigigium to Gymnemna, because this changing is very important. The body reacts in a different manner, and the cell reaction which you can get is very essential. Sometimes you can get very easy approach in maintaining the sugar levels because of change in the mother tincture. So I used to use Gymnemna, and Gymnemna, let us see that it has been proved by Lieutenant Colonel R.N. Chopra. The common name, it is Mesharingi, or it is also called as Gurmar in India. Clinical, whenever Indian drugs are mentioned, they are mentioned very typically. The clinical use is mentioned. It is sugar killer. It is given in italics, sugar killer. And what he says, so next sentence is that, excellent medicine for diabetes mellitus. Also efficacious in poisonous snake bites. This I have never used. So that's why I will not talk regarding the snake poisons or that, because if I have experience, I used to talk. If I don't have, I clearly say I don't use it. Because no, I have not seen a single case in my homeopathic practice for the snake bite. So we must talk about our own approach, our own scope, where we have a scope. Urinary symptoms are typical of the hyperglycemia, are typical of diabetes mellitus. Urinary, what he says, profuse urination loaded with sugar. After passage of urine, patient explains this passing of urine in large quantities has made me very weak. Patient cha vakya far mahatvacha hai. Doctor, evdi lagvi hoti na par thakva yeun jata. This is very important. Some patient talks in this sense. They get weakness because of profuse urination. First think about the Gymnemna, then don't think about the Sigigium Jam in that case. In Sigigium Jam, when you are thinking, prickly heat in upper part of the body is keynote of thinking about the Sigigium Jam. Here the keynote is that weakness which is produced because of profuse urination. That sentence itself suggests the Gymnemna sylvester. So, those remedies, whenever you are thinking about the mother tinctures also, you must think before that when to use Sigigium or when not to think about the Sigigium, or when to think about the Gymnemna sylvester. So these are the most essential things in practice. Just casually don't approach your remedy, or casually you don't give the homeopathic remedy to the patients. Then next sentence is that burning all over the body, diabetic carbuncle. See, this is what I always look for. Diabetic carbuncle, and it is a very, very dangerous situation if carbuncle is there. In patients of diabetes mellitus, the carbuncle develops. It is even in allopathy, it has been said that mortality rate is very high in such types of patients. And see, you have directly a pathological symptom in your Materia Medica. it shows that there is generalized burning all over the body followed with a diabetic carbuncle. Then think about this remedy. Instead of thinking of sijijanja, think about jimnimna, which you can use for the patients in such types of situation. So that symptom, don't forget carbuncle. It is a very very hard boil with an induration with a big pus formation inside at that site, and this is generally an indication of a diabetes mellitus. Tongue, it has been mentioned there is great thirst, but that is common of diabetes. Another feature which he mentions over there is sexual system, weakness of sexual power. So there is tremendous weakness at the sexual level, impotency, a commonest complication of a diabetes mellitus. Think about this remedy. It has been given, mentioned for that purpose. So one should not forget this remedy for 2-3 important features. First important feature which we have discussed, that profuse urination producing severe weakness, first important feature. Second important feature, a diabetic carbuncle if you will find, think about this remedy. And third important feature, that is the impotency associated with the diabetes, this is the thing. So you can start with this mother tincture till, and how much time it should continue till you settles the patient's future. It is required till your patient requires the mother tincture in the material form, because it depends. For example, today one patient come to me. I have started him. He is there with me since 3 months, and he came for the hypertension, and his blood pressure was 230 by 100. 230 by 100. I have started him with baratamur and along with the Rahulpia mother tincture. So I have started 15 drops in the morning, 15 drops in the evening, and I checked every 15 days. And now, since last month, it is reducing. Now it is 140 by 90 in last month. So I reduced the doses of Rahulpia. Today I have checked, it is 130 by 80, so again I have reduced the dose of Rahulpia. So you have to look for it also. If your constitutional is working, then automatically the requirement of the mother tincture automatically decreases. That you have to look for, and you have to tackle that accordingly. Potency mentioned by him is mother tincture 3x and 6, but I have not used 3x or 6. I am using only the mother tincture of Gymnemna sylvestra. So we have discussed about another mother tincture. First is Sijijum, second is Gymnemna, and third one should not forget, which I am using. If you are not getting a good results with a Sijijum jam and a Gymnemna, think about third one, again an Indian remedy, a Sepalandra indica. This is very important. This remedy is again might be a new for number of students. So Sepalandra indica, it is also called as Telakucha. Indian brewer who has worked with lot of Indian remedies from Calcutta, Dr. S.C. Ghosh. You will find that if you will read the Indian drugs from the Borix Matra Medica, number of times the brewer was Dr. S.C. Ghosh. So he is the first brewer. The clinical which are given regarding this remedy, diabetes mellitus and insipidus, both things he has mentioned over there. Skin affections, jaundice and dropsy. See, it is associated with the dropsy, it is associated with skin affections, it is associated with the jaundice along with a diabetes mellitus. See, variations are there while using the mother tinctures also. It is not one and fixed thing that every patient you should start with Sijijum jam. It's not like that. You have to think when you are using the remedy. If patient is having diabetes mellitus associated with jaundice or associated with skin affections, associated with basically edema in lower extremity, instead of thinking about Sijijum jam, you can think about the Sepalandra indica. Okay. Now he has mentioned mental symptoms also. Mental symptoms are very important. which if they are mentioned over there. It has been mentioned regarding the sepalandra indica. Patient looks morose. What is morose? मरोजचा अर्थ मरोज सल्की हे जे फ्युचर्स आहेत हे फ्युचर्स समजणं परसिव करणं फार गरजेचं आहे. मरोज म्हणजे दुर्मुखलेला चेहरा ज्याचा चेहरा संपूर्णपणे असा सॅड दिसतो विच यू डोंट हॅव टू आस्क यू पेशंट विल नॉट गोईंग टू टेल यू दॅट डॉक्टर माझा चेहरा तसा आहे उदास असतो काय असं नाही पेशंट सांगणार. यू कॅन वॉच दॅट ऑन हिज फेस दॅट इज व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट थिंग that you have to look for is maroz yes you can see the face of the patient and you can find he's absolutely dull maroz not doesn't have interest in life absolutely sad. If you ask why you are looking sad you can he says kai doctor kai the diabetes jagta yet nahi khata hai. This is very typical where their face itself shows that very important feature. Morose, fretful manje ka fretful chidka irritable disinclined to do anything so indifference is there. Fretful is irritable indifference to anything everything so there is no interest for anything. See here you have ample things in order to prescribe the sepalandra indica. It is not on the basis of only diabetes. You can get directly mentals which are observable mentals in the patient, which you can perceive in the patient. So there even their attendants can explain if wife is also along with him, if husband is along with him. They talks in this sense. Doctor, he kadhi ashe chidke navte ho. आजकाल खूप चिडचिड करतात दे ऑर इवन वॉइस वर्सा बोथ थिंग्स आर पॉसिबल बट इट इज क्वाईट कॉमन. वन मोर फ्युचर इज द ग्लुमी. ग्लुमी म्हणजे काय? ग्लुमी इज खिन्न सेम दॅट दे आर ॲब्सोल्युटली ग्लुमी दे आर ॲब्सोल्युटली डल नेवर हॅव इंटरेस्ट इन एनीथिंग द सॅडनेस विच इज एक्सप्रेसिंग फुल ऑफ सॅडनेस and they looked alone sit alone look never look to anyone and you can watch that is they are so it is very close to sepia like features. If this disturbed sepia is there you can find or if disturbed natrum is there you can get such types of features in the patient. Muraticum group generally you can get such types of features. Gloomy memory partially gone and that is again one more thing one should not forget. Forgetfulness is the common symptom of a diabetes mellitus. Those who are having high blood sugar levels, memory loss is always there. See how many features of diabetes mellitus associated with mentals are mentioned in sepalandra indica and we are not using this remedy. What at last one he says mentally and physically oversensitiveness. The reactions are very acute, oversensitiveness. Someone says something, he becomes irritable. Someone says something, he gets dull, he gets indifferent, he gets morose, sulky, all those features which are quite common. So diabetes associated with such and such a state, you can think about this sepalandra indica. Now one more remedy which one should not forget, that example I will give after completing this remedy, that is the acid phosphoricum. So I will suggest that how I used to think about the acid phosphoricum also. There is one more feature, generalized burning, and this is burning is quite common with the diabetes mellitus. Burning fit syndrome is associated with the diabetes mellitus. It is the neuropathy which is responsible to produce burning fit syndrome, and you can get it in both remedies. You can get it in gymnema as well as in this sepalandra indica. Urine, which is profuse urination, see, weakness and exhaustion after urination. So weakness and exhaustion after urination like gymnema, sugar in the urine, diabetes mellitus. So these are common features of diabetes mellitus which you can get in sepalandra indica. They are not uncommon, common features of diabetes mellitus. But when you are thinking about such a condition that diabetes mellitus associated with such a dull state, you must think about the Sepalandra indica in the mother tincture form. There is one more feature which is mentioned, that it which indicates heart affections also. The pulse is weak and intermittent. So old age person suffering from diabetes, suffering with mental indifference or dull state associated with weakness in the pulse level, associated with intermittent pulse, associated with edema over the lower extremities, a dropsy, it suggests that diabetic heart is there or diabetic nephropathy is there. Sepalandra indica is very important remedy to be utilized. Always think pathologically. Always think about the complications of the diabetes mellitus. So, homework for all of you is that read the diabetes mellitus from Davidson's book again, so that you can understand the diabetes in detail. And if you understand diabetes in detail, then you correlate it with the homeopathy and homeopathic mother tinctures, even with the biochemics, you can get a very good solution for your patients. So these are the three important mother tinctures I have shared with you. The potency again he has mentioned regarding it is the mother tincture 1x and 3x, but I used to use it only in mother tincture. I have not used this remedy in the 1x or 3x potency. So these are very important mother tinctures I am using in my practice regard for the diabetes mellitus, not more than that, and that's why I will not going to share any other mother tincture. But I want to share one important thing, remedy acid phosphoricum. My thought is always that if diabetic impotency, diabetes with tremendous weakness, diabetes with a debility, that is called as a debility, diabetes with debility, diabetes with weakness, diabetes with tremendous indifference towards anything, one should not forget acid phosphoricum. This remedy is always very very useful in controlling the sugar, and even you can remove the type 2 diabetes with the help of such a remedy. So that is one more remedy one always think regarding the diabetes mellitus. Now you can it is a question that how many remedies you use in practice regarding the diabetes mellitus. There is no fixed formula. You have to find it out a constitutional semilimum. So ultimately you have to deal with the human being that who is suffering from diabetes, and you have to find it out a remedy, and then accordingly you can manage the case along with those mother tinctures, even biochemic number combination number 7, which already we have discussed while discussing the biocombinations. If anyone who is new listener who have not learned regarding this biochemic aspect, there are 72 videos on biochemics which are there loaded on the YouTube channel, the Divine School of Homeopathy. Go through that so that you can even use biochemics and biocombinations in this specifically in such types of disorders in diabetes mellitus. So today I think this much is sufficient. I again suggest that you must go for understanding the diabetes before learning the remedies. So if you read them clearly, you can think about or you can handle very confidently the diabetes in the patient. You can handle all varieties of diabetes patient, even type 1, type 2, gestational, and even the diabetes because of some other causes. Only thing what requires is the confidence, and build that confidence to treat, because we have ample remedies but we don't have daring. My suggestion is that don't fear, don't keep any fear in your mind. You can handle all such situations very nicely with the help of homeopathy. So from today onwards, tackle the patients of diabetes mellitus along with diabetic complications also you can very easily handle with the help of your homeopathic medicines. Even diabetic food you can handle. My dear friend Dr. Prashant Gangwal, we are doing homeopathic MD, he has done the dissertation on diabetic food, and he has worked hard to find it out all those cases, and he was working as homeopathic diabetologist. So such things are possible when you concentrate on certain things. So my suggestion for all of you, must go learn a diabetes, and again go for the understanding different remedies from your Materia Medica to tackle all those diseases. So thank you very much for attending today's sessions. Tomorrow, it depends, mostly we'll have a session. I will let you know in the morning, but definitely I will be there at 2:30, even though Sunday is there. Because if any emergency is there, I will let you know that session is not there. Otherwise, we'll have the same session at the 2:30. Thanks for attending. And second important thing, which I have not mentioned, but the love which you are giving me, number of students there, number of homeopathic practitioners, they are reacting a very nice letter. Dr. Manjusha and Dr. both of them have written me, and it gives me again a good stimulus to teach you again and again something which I know and sharing with you. So thanks a lot. It's really appreciable. She has written all those things, but I know that I'm not that much like a god. She has mentioned that Dr. Rasal, lockdown period madhe bhetlela dev manus. I am not a god. God is there, Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, from whom we are learning and we are meeting together. So whatever credit is there, the credit always goes to those gods, Dr. Hahnemann, Dr. Kane, Dr. Boninghausen, all those were the gods for us. So thank you very much for such types of reactions, which helps to stimulate me. Thanks a lot again. We'll meet tomorrow. Thank you very much.